Streetball as a kid was the truth box. If you had weaknesses, they were exposed. If you were really good, everybody seen them. We had a streetball court right off of Sheriff Road in Fairmont Heights, Maryland, called the Kingdom. It was right on the corner, so all the cars would stop and watch us play when we were at the light. If you made it on the Kingdom court, you were pretty good. I had my fair share of being the last cut, having to wait my turn. That was very, very humbling. The highest level of streetball was playing in New York City, playing at Rucker Park. One of my guys from back at home, White Chocolate, he was a streetball legend around our area. He texted me and said, "They bumping up the Rucker Slim. Do you want to play?" And I was like, I'm in Oklahoma at the moment. I probably won't get there in time. But I was like, you know what? Let's just see if we can make it. I hopped on the flight in an hour straight from the plane to the park. I didn't let anybody know I was coming up there. New York is so small. They could just yell down the block and say, "Yo, KD's here." And that's what it felt like, because I remember I just put my shorts and jersey on and my shoes, and I look up, it's packed all the way over the gate. They playing loud music, and you see people in the high rises across the street turn their lights on and open their windows. It was just like something out of a movie. I knew White Chocolate, and I knew a couple guys on the team. The trash talk is just on another level, so when you're a pro, like, you can't just play well. It's like Floyd Mayweather boxing against a younger fighter. You gotta dominate. In an NBA game, they're just as good, so they can just use their physical strength and skill to kind of match. But out there, you gotta find an edge somehow. Those guys out on the record, they don't have a physical advantage or a skill advantage, so they try to use the mental game, and then everybody in the crowd is back in their hometown. Our team's from D.C., and we play the New York team, so everybody was against us. Everybody was talking trash to me. I couldn't go out there and just play cool. I had to elbow somebody and scream in his face, or, you know, get the crowd pumped. I hit one and back rimmed in, and then I ran down, and then the second one just went straight in. I was like, I caught a rhythm now. And then after that, I was shooting from anywhere. I mean, I hit 4 threes in a row, and 10 to 15 young kids running, jumping on me, and 20 adults. I'm seeing the whole crowd running on the floor. That much love at one time was a lot. It was like a quick burst of joy, and I haven't felt on a basketball court before. It was amazing.